Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
Zach Hahn is a big scorer. He leads Newcastle in tonight's 3A title game for the Jay County Patriots. Their leader is 6'1" senior Tyler Rigby. Tonight in Indianapolis at Conseco Fieldhouse, the home of the Indiana Pacers, it's the 3A state championship game. Tonight, a pair of teams from neighboring counties, both 20-6, meet Jay County and Newcastle. Welcome inside Conseco Fieldhouse with John Laskowski. I'm Chris Denary. This is our 3A title game, the third of four today, and should be a good one between two teams that reside very close to one another.
But they have contrasting styles. Newcastle wants to run up the floor and take a lot of three-point shots. Jay County be very patient, take their time on offense.
All right, let's take a look at the Newcastle Trojans and how they made it here to Conseco Fieldhouse. They defeated Evansville Modern Day in the Seymour semi-state after winning both their own Newcastle sectional and Newcastle regional. For Jay County, this is their first appearance in a state championship game. They won the Lafayette Jefferson semi-state last week, beating Plymouth 53-52. Should be a good one. Newcastle won a state championship in 1932. They'll try to get another one tonight. We'll hear from the coaches coming up on the Indiana Cable Network. Welcome back inside of Conseco Fieldhouse. Tonight's session is a sellout. The 3A game, Jay County and the Newcastle Trojans. Both teams are 20-6 on the year. The Patriots are looking for their first state title. Newcastle hasn't won one in over 70 years. The coaches are very excited about this game. My partner John Laskowski had a chance to talk with Craig Teagle of Jay County and Newcastle's Steve Bennett.
Well, it's going to be a contrast in styles. We're going to go and aim her high and let her fly. We'll let it go from anywhere on the court. And they're going to be very patient offensively, and they execute. They take the shots they want to take. So it's going to be an interesting game from that standpoint.
Well, it's going to be a very difficult contest for us. They're awful athletic. They got two kids that are probably going to be Division I players. We're not that fortunate at this point, but we've played great team basketball all year. And if we continue to do so both offensively and defensively, I think we got a shot.
Well, the building is energized. We're getting you ready for a great night of high school basketball. We'll have the starting lineups and the opening tip when we return. Sellout crowd tonight in Indianapolis at Conseco Fieldhouse for our night session of the Indiana State High School Boys Basketball Finals. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance brings us the starters tonight. John, what are the matchups you're most interested in tonight?
Well, Hahn's a terrific point guard, but he shoots and scores a lot. Rigby is the leading scorer, just 11.7. This is a very team-oriented game Jay County plays.
All right, we're getting you ready for the tip. Our officials tonight, Bob Anderson, Grady Smith, and Stan Foreman. There you see Zach Hahn. I like what Steve Bennett had to say. Hey, we're going to let it fly. But they only average 58 points a game. Jay County, in their slower style, averages a point better at 59.
That's true. They're both just under 60. It's going to be an interesting contrast. We'll see which one can run the game they want.
And the Patriots have the basketball. The white uniforms working against the green-clad Newcastle Trojans. Back in a state championship situation for the first time since 1984.
See the patience that Steve Bennett talked about. Rigby is number 5, 6'1", averages 11 points a game.
Three-point shot just barely off the front edge of the rim by Corey Comer. Hit the game winner last week as they beat Plymouth in overtime. Newcastle right to the hoop and nearly got it. That was Luke Bennett. So Luke Bennett to the free throw line. This is not his dad, but it's Steve Bennett, ninth year as the head coach at Newcastle, 12 years an assistant to Jim Cruz in Evansville, 153-55. Native of Marshall, Illinois, he attended Eastern Illinois. And once he got a taste of Indiana basketball at Evansville, he said, hey, I'm going to coach in the high school ranks. Craig Teagle went to Blackford High School and also attended Ball State University in his eighth year, 104-81. And Newcastle on the board with a free throw.
Newcastle man-to-man.
Nice pass by Comer, but it goes right through the legs of Clint Mullenkamp, and the Trojans force the turnover.
Jay County plays man-to-man. They play a motion offense, but they're very team-oriented. Craig Tagle's not sure which player is going to be the leading scorer from game to game, and that's a true definition of a team. Each of those five starters can step up and score some points.
Yeah, Rigby is their only double-figure scorer at nearly 12 points a game. That's Zach Hahn, guarded by Bruggeman. Nice pass by Hahn down low. Galleon throws it away, and Newcastle throws it away. And I look over at Steve Bennett, and I think he says, hey, Zach, you're the shooter. Shoot the ball.
One of the things Steve Bennett talked about at practice, don't change. Do what we do at home. And it looks like the turnovers here early for both teams are something the coach is not familiar with. Maybe some jitters here as the game gets started.
That's Rigby with the ball using the screen. Ducks under the defender, missed the shot, and chased the goal. Outstanding 6'3 sophomore athlete for the Trojans.
Steele is just a sophomore.
Missed the shot was Freeburg. And then he goes sliding across the 10-second line.
Layup and missed. I tell you, neither of these teams have been here before. First time, he just shot that right over the basket.
Ruggeman bouncing, works against Hahn. You can see Jake County taking its time. Rigby had the ball swatted away by Bennett. Now Comer deep in the lane. And Comer walks. He's been a varsity player since his freshman year. He's a 6'1 junior. His father is the Jay County girls coach.
He understands basketball. I didn't watch it since he was a young man.
And
John Redder in. Usually he starts, but 42 Clint Mullenkamp started in his place. So Redder's a 6'2 senior, normally starts in the game early.
He averages 6.5 points, nearly 5 rebounds, good shooter at 52%. Trojans have a 1-0 lead.
Traveling called inside again on Freeburg, trying to get the ball on the block.
And both teams now with 2 turnovers. I think we have, what, we have 4 turnovers and 3 shots attempted.
We need more shots taken, all right? Let's see if that can happen.
Steve Bennett can't like it. You heard what he said. Hey, we're going to eye it and fly it.
But nobody likes to play defense. Let's see how that affects his Newcastle team. They just soon have that quick shot so they can get down and score on their own. They're going to play a little more defense than they will normally in their regular game.
Newcastle backed off. They were giving Redder that shot. And we have a foul off the ball, and it's called on Newcastle. And it's on Matt Galleon.
Push inside. Jake County's trying to get on the block and set position. And Galleon picks up that foul. Jake County is a team that has beaten 3 ranked teams. They are unranked themselves. And 2 of those games in overtime. So they know how the upset bug works. They are unranked. Newcastle ranked 10th in the final poll.
And Rigby hits the first shot of the game for Jake County. Now Bennett a 3 the other way.
Now Newcastle breaks the ice finally. Luke Bennett with a 3-point shot.
So it's 4-3. Trojans have a 1-point lead. 3 minutes gone by here in the first quarter. Both teams playing man-to-man defense. Zach Green works against the goal, the sophomore. And look how patient, John, the Jay County is.
Some scoring here, not as much as these teams would like, but his Rigby up from the outside, he lets fly a three-pointer. And then Newcastle, nice dish there by Hahn, and Bennett gets his three-pointer.
Patriots probe the defense. Comer cut off there by Stegall. And Jake Haney will come back and run that half-court offense, but Rigby will fire and hit again.
Same shot he had before. They swing that ball around. He's open on the baseline and ready to take the shot.
Holding foul called on Scott Bruggeman against Zach Hahn.
Zach Hahn is left-handed, so you got to be conscious of that. He fakes into the middle with the right, but he's going to come back to the left. And holding foul called on Jake County. Here's Rigby again, got a good screen, and hits that shot.
Well, you talk about Zach Hahn. He had 25 points, six threes against Evansville Modern Day. In the regional, he had 25 against Roncalli and 36 against Danville. He misses his first shot there.
He let that one fly. Steve Bennett talked to me about him shooting way outside in the semi-state down in Seymour.
Well, he's another in the long line of very good guards in Newcastle. I've been around a number of them as the voice of Butler basketball. Brandon Miller, Darnell Archie, and this year, Bruce Horan becoming Butler's all-time three-point leader. And, of course, Steve Alford, who is in the building tonight, the Iowa coach, watching his alma mater play. Jake County has an early two-point lead. Patriots 6 and the Trojans 4. Jake County out to an early 6-4 lead. We played halfway, a little bit more than halfway through the first quarter here at Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. The Patriots 20-6, and they got their 20th win last Saturday in overtime over Plymouth, 53-52. And that young man, Corey Comer, hit the game-winning field goal in overtime to give him the win with 2 seconds to play, and he did it, Laz. He didn't play a lot. He was in foul trouble really the whole day. He had 8 points, but hit the big game winner.
A shot he'll always remember. It brought his team to the state championship.
Zach Hahn being chased. He's a left-hander. Hahn to the hoop and gets his first two.
That's a tough move. He's going to his offhand, the right side, and able to bank that in. Hahn really trying to get Newcastle started. They're not used to playing this slowdown game. And that's one reason Jake County's so tough to beat, because you don't see this style a lot. And Jake County's really perfected how to get another team out of their game. And they, as I mentioned, they've upset some teams and won some overtime games.
Bennett knocked that away for Newcastle. Trojans have gone to the bench. 6'6 junior Bobby Carroll is in for the first time.
Newcastle has the height advantage. Let's see if that's an advantage for them in the rebounding end at both ends.
Randy Evans is on the floor, a senior, averaging nearly 9 points off the bench for Jay County. He's a good three-point shooter, 35%. He's made 44 of them on the year. He handles the ball right now. Bruggeman in the lane, got around Hahn, missed it. Rebound tipped out of there. But Jake County gets the offensive rebound. And Carroll makes the nice steal, and here comes Hahn. Fourth turnover against the Patriots. Hahn. Tower had a look at a three-point shot, but thought better of it.
Now Steve Bennett's called a play. Looks like it's for Hahn. Screen on the top.
Tower hands it right back to Hahn. And he's going to launch a long three. Doesn't get it. And John Redder, the rebound for the Patriots.
Jake Cannon moves from side to side, and they cut low on the baseline.
And they'll run you through that half-court offense quite a long time.
They keep the lane open, so if one of the outside players beats his man, he's got the drive to the basket.
Stegall with a nice play on the rebound. Here comes Newcastle. Nice stop and go drive by Bennett.
You can see Newcastle very well coached fundamentally. Good stop and go move that time. Caught Jake County behind. Let's watch here. There's the play. Good give and go. Doesn't count when you foul the second time. One foul per play.
Randy Evans is called for that foul. He, Bruggeman, and Mollenkamp now each with a personal foul. Newcastle has two personals here in the quarter. There you see, not a lot of shots taken thus far, and our score is not very big at all. Three-point try barely grazed the front of the rim by Brian Hazelman for the first time for Newcastle.
Rebound by Newcastle, stepped on the line, out of bounds to Jake County.
Patriots number four, Luke Getz.
Well, Jake County in Portland, Indiana, they have an enrollment of just shy of 1,200. Newcastle, of course, located just off I-70 to the east of Indianapolis, about an hour away in Henry County. And it's Randy Evans from the corner, the 45th of the year for the 6'1 senior.
Jake County's taking advantage of their outside shots.
That's all they have. They have three threes right now. Stegall loads it up off the top of the backboard.
That's a quick shot, the style Newcastle likes, but so far the patience of Jake County leading this game by three.
5'5 sophomore Luke Getz now at the point for the Patriots. They'll probably, I would say, Laz, they'll probably work for the final shot.
Absolutely. They're going to wait this out. 35 seconds.
Look at them when they catch that ball. They get it right in that triple threat position.
One the point guard, then they have four, two on each side, four players inside. But again, keep that lane open in case somebody can make a drive. Watch the 5 second call as you try to run this clock down, closely guarded.
I'll tell you, if you're doing a teaching tool right now, watching Jake County handle the ball the way they pass it, catch, and get that ball in that triple threat position.
Great discipline. Time to get going now to get a shot.
Evans got his man in the air. It was partially deflected by Stegall. It's saved. Evans has it. He'll have a shot at the buzzer. And the first quarter, Jake County hit three threes. Luke Bennett hit one for the Trojans. And the Patriots have a 9-6 lead on the Indiana Cable Network. Jake County has three shots from behind the arc, and they lead Newcastle after one quarter, 9-6. You talk about the Newcastle Trojans, a member of the North Central Conference, state finals history. This is their ninth appearance. They won it back in 1932, and a week ago, they beat Evansville Modern Day 60-44 in the semi-state. They trailed 39-37 after three quarters. Last, they outscored Modern Day 23-5 in the fourth.
They are an explosive team and can come back, and that's their leader, Zach Hahn. Thought he got fouled on that shot, but he's tied the game up.
He has 5 points. That's his first three, the 69th of the year. He shoots 40% from behind the arc, a 47% field goal shooter, and he leads them at 18.5 points a game. Ruggeman leaves it short, tip. Rigby, left hand, off the back of the iron. Still loose. Rebounded by Mollenkamp, and a foul over the top against Newcastle.
Let's watch that last basket by Hahn. Comes right off a screen, catch and shoot, left-handed, makes it. Jake County really hitting the boards in that last sequence. Once that shot goes up, they all crash it and got the foul for the free throw.
Second foul on Ryan Freeburg. Mollenkamp, a 62% free throw shooter, misses the first. Misses them both.
Good block out that time by Freeburg for Newcastle. Got the easy rebound. Steve Bennett calls out the play and see if it involves Zach Hahn. Stegall.
Yeah, he's a nice sophomore.
He is just a sophomore, can really hit that outside shot. Saw their practice on Thursday. And he is an up-and-coming player for Newcastle, already the second leading scorer here on this team.
15.6 rebounds, blocked shot by Bennett against Rigby. Trojans by two, 11-9. Stegall on the board for the first time. Evans has hit a three, ducks inside the line, nice bounce pass. Well, can't get it to fall. Rebound, Bruggeman underneath, has it blocked. Freeburg got it, here's Hahn. Uses the screen. Right back. Nice bounce pass by Hahn. And he's rewarded with the assist. Ryan Freeburg to hoop.
Well, he keeps his head up as he's dribbling. You know he's looking for the shot, but a good team player that he is, he also knows when he gets double teamed, found Freeburg open on the other side.
Rigby has two threes. Now he has it poked away.
Newcastle's just become more aggressive. Let's see how Zahn Arhan takes that ball in. There he is, three guys around him. He finds the open man and gets the ball to him. Newcastle got caught up in the slow game that Jake County was playing, and they kind of played a slow style. They're not used to doing that. They've come down, made some aggressive plays, especially on the defensive end, that's got their rhythm back into this game.
And they have a four-point lead of 13-9. They have scored the game's last 7 points.
Now a little zone by Newcastle.
Long three missed. Randy Evans, and then from behind, Stegall has it poked away.
No talk by his teammates. He couldn't see Jake County come up from behind. That's a good steal. But Newcastle now in a zone. They want to show something different to Jake County. Well, let's see. They switch back to the man-to-man. That was just one time down the floor in zone.
Evans looks inside. We haven't mentioned Corey Comer's name much here of late. Their leading scorer, Rigby, is on the bench right now. Bruggeman with a long three.
Took his time and had a wide open shot. Bruggeman nails that one. Jake County makes just under 6 3-point shots a game. They've got four already.
That's all they have. They have not made a 2-point shot. Hahn off the dribble.
What a good looking shot Zach Hahn has. Again, going to the right. That's tougher. That's twice now he's made a move to the right. So you can't shade him one way or the other.
3-point Newcastle lead. Comer. Evans has made one out there. And the Patriots patient. Tempo slows down when Jake County has the ball. Mullenkamp right to the basket, off the back of the iron. They fight for it, rebound, and a foul.
Jake County, a scrappy bunch. They're able to come up with that rebound. Let's watch the last two baskets. Jake County, outside shot is drained by Bruggeman. And then Zach Hahn again on the move. Very quick release. Able to get that two-pointer for Newcastle.
Drew Tower picked up the foul for Newcastle. His first, team foul number four against the Trojans. Nearing the halfway mark of the second quarter. Newcastle in the green, leads by three. Jay County led 9-6 at the end of the first quarter. Long three, short. Zach Green missed it. Rigby's back on the floor. He's out there guarding Bennett. Now Bruggeman guarding Hahn.
This is the guy you want the ball in his hands. See what he can create.
Offensive rebound for Newcastle. They reset it.
And they go right back to Hahn. Pressure on that shot. Not one Steve Bennett may have wanted him to take.
And they're going to call Stegall for walking. He made a quick move. Fourth turnover now for the Trojans. But they have a three-point lead. Newcastle 15, Jay County 12. Second quarter of the 3A title game on the Indiana Cable Network. Newcastle has a three-point second quarter lead after Jay County led by three after the first quarter. This is the 3A state championship game in Indiana. Coming up, you can be a witness to history. As back in the mid-80s, the Marion Giants became the second team in state history, joining the Wonder Five of Franklin to win three straight Indiana State Championships. And Crispus Attucks back in the 50s won 45 consecutive games. The Tigers led by the great one, the Big O, Oscar Robertson. Well, those records could be matched tonight by the Wildcats of Lawrence North. Greg Oat, Mike Conley lead the Wildcats in search of their third straight state championship game. It's a rematch of a year ago when the Wildcats beat Muncie Central. You're talking about also, John, a Muncie Central Bearcat team and school that has won numerous state championships here in Indiana.
They've won eight, the most of any team in Indiana high school history.
Nice bounce pass, and John Redder lays it in.
Good set play there on the out of bounds by Craig Teague. Craig Teagle. It's a very important part of the game, Chris. If Jay County gets a lead, and I'm talking 6, 7, 8 points, they can really let the air of that ball.
That ball may go on ice, won't it?
That's exactly right, and they know how to play that game. So Newcastle's got to stay even all the time, or this game could really change.
Stegall went to the hoop. The sophomore has struggled here early. And now Jay County has the ball, trailing by one.
Newcastle can't afford those turnovers. They got to get a shot every time down the floor.
Each team with four turnovers here in the first half. Ruggeman against Hahn. Out there behind the three-point arc where they have four three-pointers and a two-pointer. That layup by Redder was their first two-point shot of the game.
Always under control, and they drive to the basket. They don't have anything. They get it back outside.
And Comer right to the basket. He missed the easy layup. Rebounded, and Stegall fouls. Well, Comer got to the basket. We've seen a couple of those shots, John, that were, you say they're relatively easy, but when you're in a state championship environment, you go to the basket, I'm not sure anything's easy.
You just don't know. He puts it right on the glass. It just doesn't go, but they stayed after it, got to the line.
And Stegall is called for the foul. That's his first, team foul number five. Redder at the line. So now he has a chance to tie the game with his second, 59% free throw shooter.
Looks good on that one.
We were tied at 6, tied at 9, and now tied at 15. Third tie. 2 minutes to play in the first half. Boy, Hahn finds his way to the basket. Cut off there. Now he catches, works on Bruggeman, takes him right to the basket with a right hand, hit the side of the backboard.
Redder right there with a hand up. Made that shot. Miss. Even the backboard just hit the side of the backboard.
Ruggeman. Jake County's very capable of winding the final 90 seconds off the clock, but they'll go right to the basket. Can't get it. Tipped up. Tipped. And rebounded by the Trojans. Big Bobby Carroll got it. 94 feet away, Jake County making his life tough.
Nice double team. Craig Tiggle's got to be pleased the way his team's played. It's a low-scoring game. I think he likes that. He's controlled the tempo of the game. His team's battling.
Craig Tiggle, Blackford High School from Hartford City. Nice move to the hoop and a foul. Drew Tower went strong, and he's rewarded with a pair of free throws.
I think that's an advantage for Newcastle. They've got a little height inside. They haven't been going in a lot. They can get that ball on the block, let one of their big men take a move and get that shot and the foul. Of course, they've got Zach Hahn on the outside who can control that game. So they could have a nice inside-outside game against Jay County.
Corey Comer picked up the foul. Tower misses the free throw. Newcastle now 1 of 3 at the line. Jake County 1 of 4. Really all day long, we've not seen great free throw shooting here today, Laz.
No, the nerves are out there. I think these kids realize how important this is. Seen a lot of them hit the rim, bounce right around and go in, but not many straight through the rim.
I just think watching the rims all day long, too, they're very tight rims. That you really have to swish it. To be sure you're going to make it, your best bet is to swish it. If you're going to use any bit of the rim, you just don't know what kind of roll you're going to get.
Well, Steve Bennett tells his team, don't miss short. I don't care if you throw it over the backboard, but a short miss never goes in. You got at least got a chance if you hit the back of the rim.
16-15 Newcastle. We only have 37 seconds left to play in the first half. Very low scoring game. Jake County will work for the final shot. Ruggeman chased by Hahn. 13 seconds to play. Time for the Patriots to go toward the hoop. Rigby with a long three. He banks it in. Tyler Rigby banks it in to give Jay County a 2-point halftime lead. A deep three by Tyler Rigby at the buzzer, and Jay County has a 2-point lead. Craig Teagle of Jay County, the head coach, standing by with JMB.
All right, coach, it looks like you got the tempo that you wanted in the first half, and then you get a huge lift with that banked in three. You're feeling pretty good about yourself right now.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's a tough shot. He probably got fouled on it, but it went in, so we'll take it. The main thing is we got controlled tempo. They're more physical than us. We can't get anything going to the basket because they bump us off everything we're trying to do, so we're going to have to hit some outside shots. But we got to be patient, play with poise. That's going to be the key.
All right, you have that done defensively. You're really hedging and getting a lot of defensive help on Zach Hahn, and that's gone well as well.
It has, but you know what? I don't think we're doing a good enough job. I thought we let him get around that ball screen a couple times. We're supposed to widen him out a little more than we did. Every time you make a mistake against Newcastle, you pay for it.
Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you very much.
Chris and Laz.
All right, thanks, JMB. Newcastle is known as the three-point shooting team, but Jay County's hit five of them here in the first half. They have a two-point lead in Indianapolis. Jay County has a two-point lead at the half. The 3A state championship game in Indiana, 18-16. Patriots, courtside here with John Laskowski. I'm Chris Denary. If you're Steve Bennett, the head coach in Newcastle, you want a faster-paced game, you want to eye it and fly it. They're 6 of 14, so they're shooting nearly 50%, but 14 shots is not enough.
Yeah, they're not getting the number of shots that they want to get, but credit Jay County, Craig Teagle, for the style of game that he has. Very surprised that Jay County's hit 5 3-point shots. They average 5.5 made per game, so they're already at their limit, but Newcastle's not giving any 2-point shots to take. It's a close game.
All right, let's take a look at our first half highlights as we try to break it down for you. This game started with Tyler Rigby getting hot from beyond the arc.
Well, Jay County's got all good shooters. The game's gone back and forth, so our highlights mix. Newcastle, and there's Zach Hahn, their leading scorer. He loves to take that ball to the basket, hit from the outside. Jay County's story has been from the outside. They get set, they can make that shot. Newcastle likes to shoot on the run, as Zach Hahn did there going to the right. And this shot there did get fouled after the horn sounded, but that ball drops in off the backboard to give Jay County the 2-point lead.
Tyler Rigby has 3 of Jay County's 5 first half 3-point field goals, and that one gave them the lead. Patriots at the half by 2 on the Indiana Cable Network. 18-16, Jay County has the halftime lead, a first half that featured 5 lead changes, 3 ties. Newcastle, its biggest lead of 4. Jay County led by 3. Chris Denary and John Laskowski, what do you think both coaches are talking about in the locker room at the half, Laz?
Well, Craig Teagle's pretty pleased. It's hard for him to get his inside shots, but the outside shot is going. It seems to be harder for Steve Bennett's Newcastle team to play the slow game. They're not getting the number of 3-point shots that they want. He's got to figure out how to get some shots and get some scoring.
Our halftime stats are sponsored by Ball State University. And let's have a look. Look at Newcastle. They're shooting the ball much better than Jay County, but the Patriots have made it count on the offensive glass.
They have. I think that is reversed. Newcastle's 2 of 5 on the 3-point shooting. They've only gotten 5 shots, but Jay County's 5 out of 12, so that's the difference in the ball game right there. And Jay County also out-rebounding Newcastle. 15-9 I have on my stat sheet, and 7 offensive rebounds, so the board advantage definitely to Jay County.
All right, Jay County has a 2-point lead, 18-16 at the half. We head to break. Sellout crowd tonight at Conseco Fieldhouse. This is our 3A title game on the Indiana Cable Network. At the half, Jay County with the 2-point lead over Newcastle, 18-16, getting ready for the third quarter. JMB is standing by with the head coach of the Newcastle Trojans, Steve Bennett.
Well, coach, you know, you only had 14 shot attempts in the first half, and I'm fairly certain you probably want to up that just a little bit in the second.
Well, we've done a poor job of rebounding. We've given them 8 offensive rebounds, and we've gotten 1. And basically, a game like this is going to be won with your defense and your rebounding. There's not going to be a lot of shot attempts, so you got to make the most of it. So we've got to tighten up our defense and make some plays there, but then get some more open looks. We got to screen better and cut better, the things that coaches always say.
How do you get Zach Hahn going in the second half?
Well, I mean, we got to get him open, but we play defense for a while, so there's not a lot of attempts. So, you know, the more we can get him the ball, the better, and we're going to plan on doing that.
Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Chris, back to you.
Thanks, JMB. And Laz, I think Steve Bennett knows this is going to be a low possession game. So you really have to be close to perfect in what you do to make sure you get a win, because you're not going to have that many opportunities at the basket.
Just as he talked about, the defense will be the key. Hahn's only got 7 points. He scores 18 a game. And see, it's going to be a low scoring game. So Steve Benz prepared his team for defense and rebounding in the second half.
Well, look at Chase DeGaulle. He averages 15 points a game. He only had two in the first half. For Jay County, Tyler Rigby had 3 threes, including that banker at the end of the half, 9 points. And then Ruggeman, Redder, and Evans with 3 points apiece.
So we know it's going to be a slow style game. Craig Keel's not going to change what he does. That means that Steve Bennett, Newcastle Trojans, have to change their style, play more defense, get more rebounds, and have less impact on offense. They average 21 3-point attempts per game. They make about 8. They're going to be nowhere near that tonight.
Well, it's a very historic day here at Conseco Fieldhouse, especially tonight what Lawrence North is trying to do with a chance to win 3 straight state titles and win their 45th consecutive game. But we also witness history today, because Hauser's in the record books now as a state champ in 1A. They beat Tri-Central 64-36. And then Forest Park, for the second consecutive year, beat Fort Wayne Harding 61-55. They played for the second consecutive year. And Muncie Central playing Lawrence North for a second consecutive year. John, so much is made out of Lawrence North. We saw Muncie Central last week. What do they have to do tonight to have a chance to win?
Muncie Central's got a very good team. They're good outside shooters. To beat Lawrence North, you've got to hit the outside shot. Muncie Central concentrate on that later tonight.
Well, they'd like to make history of their own.
Absolutely. The 9th state championship, the most in Indiana history.
So Jay County has the ball. White uniforms for the Patriots. Out of Jay County, the entire county attending the high school. Newcastle located in Henry County. Both located in about mid-central Indiana, northeastern Indiana, if you will. Not quite the Fort Wayne area. And here's a nice move, but it's missed. Rebounded by Jay County, and Comer right to the hoop, and he gets his first field goal.
And right away, Jay County picks up another offensive rebound and takes advantage of it and gets a 2-point basket.
On the drive, and Ruggeman the foul.
Hahn is very quick and tough to stop. Watch out. Newcastle had trapped Jay County inside, but Comer finds a left-handed shot, gets a soft roll.
Hahn being chased by Ruggeman. That's DeGaulle. He's got to find his way to the hoop, and Rigby blocked his shot. He blocked it again, but this time Stegall draws the foul.
Well, I like Stegall there. He went after it again, even though he got that shot blocked. He tries to recover very quickly, stayed with it. Rigby fouled him. It's another area Steve Bennett can take advantage of, and that's scoring from the free throw line.
Two shots for Chase Stegall.
They were only 2 of 4 in the first half, so only got 4 attempts.
And the free throw left short.
Once you get there, though, you got to make it.
Three-point lead for Jay County. 3 points now for Stegall. One minute gone by in the third quarter. Zach Green with Clinton Mullenkamp, who got the start. Mullenkamp is just a sophomore at 6'3". That's Ruggeman out front. He's a 5'10 junior. Zach Green, what they want to do, they can almost lull you to sleep, lads.
They really can, and make maybe a backdoor cut or a drive to the basket. See that yellow paint? It's pretty wide open.
Drive by Comer, blocked, but a foul first. The shot was blocked by Ryan Freeberg, but I think the foul was called underneath, and it was on Matt Gallion.
Let's see what happened here. Good drive. There's a spin move by Comer, and that foul came from behind. Freeberg did block that shot. Newcastle's got to put more pressure on the passes, on the dribbling that takes place. They've got to create some turnovers and tougher shots. Jay County still controlling the tempo of this game, And that's not a good thing. A three-point lead may not be big in some games, but the way Jake County plays, a missed shot by Newcastle. And now you're a two-possession game. And that's big.
I think you're right, Les. They've got to get out and put pressure on because they're just allowing Jake County to make those easy entry passes. There's no pressure there.
They're used to just scoring the next time down the floor, and that's not the kind of game this is going to be.
Bennett works against Zach Green, takes the shot, missed it.
Not a good shot for Newcastle, and no rebounding as well.
And because now you know that Jay County's going to come out and on this possession take 20 to 40 seconds.
And nobody likes to play defense that long.
Rigby thought about the bounce pass to Mollenkamp.
Very well coached team. That pass may have been deflected away, so he decided to hold on to it. Let's look for a better shot.
Can't get better than that.
And there it is. Outside shot by Rigby. So now it's a 7-point lead. And that's just what I was talking about, how quickly this thing can get up there.
Hahn goes to the basket, missed it, got his own rebound and count it. Zach Hahn with a second effort, got the rebound. And now a chance for a three-point play the old-fashioned way.
Well, that's what a leader does. Watch, he takes it upon himself. Not a good shot there, but somehow finds the rebound right off the back of Brueggemann. Puts it up, gets fouled. That's why he's going to be a great player next year as well.
John Redder is in. He had 3 first half points. There you see Zach Green going to the bench.
52, Bobby Carroll returns to the Trojans.
And there she is, numbers. Their leading scorer, their leading assist man, and he is in double figures with 10. So an important three-point play by Zach Hahn. And Rigby again, this time it's short. And now Newcastle, really into the tempo they want there. The missed shot, Hahn will fire.
There you saw it, the quickest shot that Jay County's taken so far in this game, and Hahn comes right back. It means he's got 6 points in the last 30 seconds to bring this to a 1-point game.
And now 13 points for Zach Hahn. 1-point lead for Jay County. Randy Evans is back on the floor for the Patriots. He had a 3-pointer in the first half and a steal. Here comes Hahn. Has the ball stripped away, but he got it back. Nice pass inside and another 3-point play opportunity for the Trojans.
That's a look, Zach Hahn. He has made the plays in the last minute to give Newcastle a lead. Let's watch now. He gets in trouble. Great steal. Coming down the floor. He's going to try to score. Gets the ball stolen. Steals it back. What a pass. And now a chance for their 3rd 3-point play in a row down the floor.
Tyler Rigby, a 2nd foul. Free throw. No good. Comer got it. But all of a sudden, Newcastle has rattled off 8 straight points. They were down 7. They now have a 1-point lead.
That's the explosion. Look how long it took them to score 18 points.
Right.
And then how quickly they were able to score those 7 coming right back here.
Brueggemann out to Comer. His 3-pointer good.
Jake County's quick in the pace. Just the opposite of what I thought would happen. They're taking quicker shots, but they made that one.
High screen for Hahn. Bennett. John Redder got the rebound, and now the Patriots have the ball. 3.5 minutes to play in the 3rd quarter. Newcastle had come back and taken the lead. The Patriots got a 3 by Corey Comer. That's Rigby in the lane. Falling down was Bennett. Rigby missed. Comer the rebound with a left hand.
Offensive rebound. Jake County's just going after the more on ball, more on both ends of the floor. It's really helped him score some points.
Comer has all 8 of his points in this quarter. In fact, he has 8 of the 11. Now Hahn with the left hand.
Sweet move there, just to kiss off the backboard there. And the perfect angle of that ball to drop right in without hitting the rim.
We've had an offensive explosion in this quarter, John.
It really is. And I think that favors Newcastle more than it does Jake County.
We had 34 total points in the first half. We have 22 already here in the third quarter, and we haven't even played 6 minutes. Evans down the lane. Stegall fouling. And Randy Evans free throws.
Again, Jay County takes their time that time, and something also good happens.
Just
to go to the line.
Is second.
And the second foul team on second. Chase Stegall. And the second team foul on Newcastle.
Two shots for Randy Evans. Hazelman,
66% free throw shooter is Evans. Brian Hazelman is on the floor for the first time of the second half for Newcastle. Played briefly in the first half. There he is wearing number 30. Evans has them both. And we have a timeout on the floor. 2:22 to play in the third. Newcastle had scored 8 straight, but now Jay County has come back, and the Patriots have scored 7 straight of their own. Jay County leads Newcastle 31-27, third quarter of the 3A state championship game. The last time the Trojans played in the state finals back in 1984. The head coach, Sam Alford, he's standing by with JMV.
Hey, Sam, a little bit different than the last time you were here. Now you're a spectator. Last time you were actually X-ing and O-ing it up just a little bit.
It is a little different, a little more relaxing now. You can enjoy the game a little better.
Do you enjoy the game as a spectator?
Oh, yes, yes. It's very enjoyable, and I just love basketball.
You think about the way Jay County's playing, and I know that Newcastle wants to get it up tempo, and they look like they're doing a pretty good job over here in the second half.
Well, they are, and I think it's probably going to come down to Hahn. He's got to take over, I think, for Newcastle. He's a very good player, and Jay County's done a great job of spreading the floor and running their stuff.
Sam, you enjoying retirement?
Enjoy it very much. Get to spend a lot of time with my grandkids, and it's worked out very well.
Well, we miss you. Come around more often, won't you?
Thank you.
Kristen Aaron.
And Zach Hahn, out of the timeout, does exactly what Sam says. And there's Sam's son, Steve Alford, the head coach of the Iowa Hawkeyes, who's back to watch his alma mater play in a state championship game.
Sam Alford was just talking. You think that Hahn heard that all the way across the court from the former mentor at Newcastle, Sam Alford?
Newcastle trails by one. Personal foul on Bobby Carroll. We talk about Steve. He is here. I also look to the corner, and Sean Alford is here, and of course Steve's brother and Sam's son. Ironically, it wasn't Steve, and there's Steve, who Steve didn't play on that 1984 team. He was the Mr. Basketball in 1983, but Sean, Sam's son, played on that 1984 state team.
His younger brother, that experience of playing with Steve, terrific for the brothers, and Steve was already in Indiana that year.
Well, I understand that Sam and Steve took off from Iowa City and made the long drive to come watch Newcastle play tonight.
Good play that time. Saving the ball out of bounds was Comer. He knocked it off a Trojan. And it comes Jay County's way. Watch this hustle. Long shot. Misses. There's the play. Comer, boom. Right into the table. They're killing him, though.
Hope nobody had a soft drink over there. And with 1:32 to play. I like that tie Steve Bennett has on.
It's Newcastle colors all the way. He does not sit down. He is up all the time on that bench, talking to his team. Very emotional coach.
Long shot by Hahn. He got it again.
Oh, wow. That's on the out of bounds play. Hahn coming to his left. That's an easier shot for him. Easy for him to make, I guess. So that ball drops for three.
6-0 run on two Hahn three-pointers. And the Trojans back in front by two.
This is the end, though, that Newcastle needs to shore up, the defense and the rebounding.
Nice drive and a reverse layup by Zach Green.
And Green found the baseline. That's a great move. There's less help when you drive the baseline. Use the reverse layup for that basket.
Hahn has 21 of Newcastle's 33. Stegall looking for help. Hazelman out there, and they get it to Hahn, who's chased by Luke Getz. Look at Hahn use the screen. Now Hazelman.
Hahn wanted that shot, but he wasn't open. That's a real heavy play. Found an open teammate for wide open three. Hazelman drilled it.
18th of the year for Bryant Hazelman. Now the final 22 seconds of the third quarter.
Newcastle, we had two runs, one by Newcastle. Jay County came back. Newcastle again has given them the lead now here as the quarter runs down.
Fadeaway jumper, that's short, and Hahn is drilled to the floor. Just two players, Comer and Hahn, going after the ball, and they collide underneath the rim.
Hahn's up, limping a little bit.
Foul on Corey Comer, his second. I don't think there was any question, though. If Hahn gets up, he's going.
Let's see what happens. Shot by Jay County off. There's the contact. Hahn was in position.
Here comes Hahn. Live action for three at the buzzer, just short. But the Newcastle Trojans, after trailing by two at the half, Zach Hahn, 14 of Newcastle's 20 third quarter points. Trojans have the lead. Newcastle junior Zach Hahn took over in the third quarter, 14 of his 21 points, and the Trojans have a three-point lead heading to the fourth quarter. This is the 3A title game coming up. It's the 4A title game, and history could be made. Back in the mid-80s, the Marion Giants, it was purple rain for Bill Green. They won three consecutive Indiana High School state championships. Back in the mid-50s, Crispus Attucks won 45 consecutive games and a state championship led by the Big O, Oscar Robertson. Tonight, a tip-off as you look at the Lawrence North Wildcats at somewhere after 8 o'clock, looking to make history tonight. Greg Oden in the house, ready to go. The Wildcats are 28-0. They've won 44 straight games, are the two-time defending 4A state champs.
Play inside, it's blocked, but a foul, so Stegall gets to go to the line.
Laz, what does it say about Greg Oden? He was here this afternoon watching the 1A, 2A games.
He loves basketball, and as a fan, he was here to watch the game. And they'll be watching him tonight, as he'll be the center of attention, literally, in that night game. Bright career for that young man as he goes on for his last high school game.
Stegall missed him, but Jay County knocks it out of bounds. No, now they're going to say Newcastle knocked it away. And do you think that Greg Oden has any idea where he ranks in Indiana high school history?
Here's the shot. And there's the tip by Newcastle.
Yeah, they're
going to
say, yeah, he was out of bounds.
Bobby Carroll tipped that ball and out of bounds to Jay County.
So the Patriots have it. Rigby catches. He has four threes in the game. Their only double-figure scorer with 12. Comer had 8 third-quarter points. Can't get it. Rebounded by Freeburg.
See, Newcastle's hitting the boards better, too. They're just two rebounds shy now of Jay County. And Hahn's done the job offensively.
Hazelman hit a three that gave Newcastle the lead at 36-33. Nice stop and go dribble by Hahn. He can't get it. Rebound kept alive, batted out of bounds. Wait, no, they are going to give it to Jay County. Steve Bennett was trying to make the call.
Coaches have a tendency to do that,
yeah,
right in front of their bench. 42. Doesn't always work.
The Patriots lineup.
Newcastle on a 9-2 run. And sophomore Clint Mullenkamp is back. He has not scored. He is the only starter for Jay County who has not put points on the board. Rigby missed it. Hahn got the rebound.
Well, Jay County's just getting one shot now, so Steve Bennett did the job at halftime by getting his team to rebound better.
Newcastle shooting 48% from the field. Nice pass to goal. Is fouled in the lane. Boy, Stegall, I don't know how Hahn saw him there, but he sort of flipped the ball up, and Stegall went right to the hoop and draws the foul. Gets a word of encouragement there from 19-year head coach Steve Bennett.
Well, that's exactly right. Going to his right, but he knew he had three guys on him, so somebody on the weak side had to be open. So he flipped a high lob pass. Worked for Newcastle.
Well, Stegall, after missing both ends of a two-shot foul, gets one there. Scott Bruggeman has to leave for Jay County. He committed his fourth foul. And Luke Yetz is back on, the 5'5 sophomore for the Patriots. That ball short, barely grazes the rim by Stegall. Four-point Newcastle lead. 6.5 minutes to play. Rigby cuts to the hoop. Doesn't get the roll, but does draw the foul.
Rigby very offensive-minded. He moves well without the ball. That's the key to his game. He doesn't score off the dribble. He gets himself open and positions to score and then gets that shot to go. Good drive that time. Put him in position to get that foul.
Stegall picks up his third foul. Look at that. If you hit short in the rim, it's like pool. You are not guaranteeing your ball's going to go in here.
That one a little better.
37-34, Newcastle by three with 6:20 to play.
A lot of substitutions now by Jay County, trying to keep the guys fresh.
Go inside to Carroll. Now Hahn out front with a three-point lead for the Trojans. He had 14 points in the third quarter. Banked it up, draws the foul. Has a chance to add two more at the free throw line.
He does a nice job. He sets his man up by going to the right before he gets the ball. Then as he gets it, he's going to the left. He can take the three-point shot, so you got to stay up on it. But if you're too close, and he'll drive by it, try to take that leading shot in. As he did there, drew the foul.
And he's had some success with now Bruggeman in foul trouble. He's 5'10". Getz is only 5'5". And Hahn is making a concerted effort to take the ball to the basket.
And if he gets help from the inside, that means Zach can pass off to an open teammate. I mean, it's really a great situation now for Newcastle offensively.
Hahn has 23.
He's an 85% free throw shooter. He's going to hit those shots from the line. What a great guy to have on your team.
Well, coming in tonight, the last three games, he had scored 86 points, averaging nearly 28.5 points a game.
That's what a leader does, and Newcastle, a very slow start. They now lead by five.
And that's a big lead in this game.
It's a big lead.
Homer spins. Missed it. Rebound tipped. Hazelman has it.
Well, they find Zach Hahn wherever on the court he is. They get him the ball as soon as they can.
Look at that behind the back dribble. Freeburg thought about it, but now a personal foul against Jay County. And Mullenkamp has his third.
So now Newcastle going to take a little more time on offense. And with a guy like Zach Hahn, that's exactly what you want to happen. Mullenkamp picks up his third, and that puts Jay County over the limit. So Newcastle shoots free throws the rest of the quarter.
Well, both teams not shooting free throws very well here tonight. Both teams at 50%. The Trojans are 7 of 14, and they miss it again, but it's kept alive by Stegall.
Good job. He didn't try to catch it, tipped it, then went after it.
You see Steve Bennett, he says, get that ball in Zach Hahn's hands. And here's Hahn. Hazelman for three.
Way short, hits the front of the rim again.
Well, Hazelman hit the big three that gave Newcastle the lead at 36-33. Now Craig Teagle wants a timeout. And the Trojans lead it by five. Newcastle 39, Jay County 34. 3A title game on the Indiana Cable Network. Newcastle Trojans lead Jay County 39-34 with 4:57 to play in the fourth quarter. We're going to take a look at our Pizza Hut. Good stuff of the game, and it's Zach Hahn.
Hahn, he can hit from the outside, that three-pointer. Gets the ball stolen, steals it back. Great assist there. He can pass the ball. And here he is on the drive. Makes that shot look easy. He's made the difference. Newcastle struggled early. Look at that line.
He's been above his scoring average because the rest of the Trojans have been below theirs. But when your point guard can also score, what a great combination that is.
23 of the 39. He has 16 after the half. Rigby, 13 points to lead Jay County. Newcastle stays in that man-to-man defense. The point guard, Scott Bruggeman, is on the bench. He has four personal fouls. We'll see at what point Craig Teagle decides to put him in.
Luke Bennett sticking right with Rigby.
Nice drive by Evans. Missed it. Rebound tipped, and Carroll has it.
Nothing seeming to drop now for Jake County. Good move to the basket. Boy, how about that one turnover here in this third and fourth quarters in the game.
Nice pass by Hahn. But Freeburg can't get it and then commits the foul.
Boy, right in front of the basket. Nobody around. He goes up and just puts it up too hard and then commits the foul on top of it. That's what gives coaches gray hair and no hair. One or the other.
Freeburg commits his third. Newcastle its fifth as a team. And now the Patriots have some work to do, again trailing by five. It's only a two possession game, but in a game like this, this is a big margin.
Their offense hasn't been as crisp here in the third and fourth quarter.
Evans to the basket, a double team, put it up, draws the foul. So Jay County gets what they want, a chance to score with the clock stopped. Bobby Carroll commits the foul. That's his second. And the sixth against Newcastle.
Randy Evans with two shots.
65% on the year is Evans. Looked good on that one.
He's 3 of 3 in this one. He has 6 points off the bench, averaging nearly 9 points a game. So a 3-point Newcastle lead, 39-36. Hahn off the screen and roll to the basket. Stops, got his own rebound. He'll put it right back up at 6'1" and score.
Just finds a way to get it done. He's not the biggest guy in there. Got a soft shot. Newcastle only had 3 points in the quarter until that shot.
One of the best juniors in the state, Zach Hahn. Nice drive by Zach Green.
Running out of room there as his body was carrying him behind the backboard. Leaned back with that right hand and got it to go.
So the lead at 3 for Newcastle as we approach the final 3 of the game. Hahn one-on-one, his runner off the back of the iron, no good. Rigby has it.
Here comes Jake Downey. They're on a little run of their own.
They wave the white pom-poms across the way behind the Jake County bench. Sellout crowd tonight at Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis for the 3A and 4A state title games. Evans drives. He thought he had a man in the corner, Corey Comer, and he threw it away. That's only the 6th Jake County turnover.
Passed it right to the bench. Maybe he saw some of those white shirts on the bench and got confused. His player was more up the court than near the baseline.
On out near the center circle.
Cleared a path for him to drive. See how all 4 Newcastle players were out on the sideline. That opened up the middle. Hahn took it right down the
pretty good lane. Play.
Good play. We need a basket.
And Jay County wants a timeout. 30-second timeout called by Craig Teagle. I saw Steve Bennett hold up 5 fingers. Pretty simple play. Hey, I want number 3, Zach Hahn, to drive it to the basket. You guys get out of his way.
Let's see. Right here, he goes to his right even. And he saw 2 big guys who had come off their men, so he just pulled up from about 8 feet. Now watch the lane. It's wide open. Jay County knows it, so they come to help. But that's just a great shot. Right in front of the basket. Sizing up. He could go right or left. And the basket. Good timeout by Craig Teagle. is a very crucial part of the game. 2:16 left. He's down five. His team takes some time to score, so they might only get three or four more shots at the basket. They've got to take advantage of each one.
Laz, I'm impressed with Zach Hahn. He's a left-hander, but I think he goes to the right more than he goes to the left.
That's great for any young player out there. If you're right-handed, work on that left. If you're left-handed, make sure you can use your right.
27 points. He has 20 here in the second half.
See if Jake County doesn't take a little quicker shot now. Still good ones, but time is running against them now.
They trail by five. 2 minutes to play. Ruggeman's back. That's Evans. Had a look at a three. Rigby to the basket, and he draws the foul.
Good move there. They stayed away from the three-point shot, made the drive, and it gives them the line with the clock stopped.
So 1:48 to play. Rigby is one of two at the line. Jay County 7 of 12 as a team at 58%. The foul on Freeburg was his fourth.
Rigby's been very steady, 81% free throw shooter, 6'1 senior. He's their leader's team.
Zach Green is back on the floor. Ruggeman leaves. He has four personal fouls. And Drew Tower is in for Newcastle, 6'4 junior. As Ryan Freeburg leaves, he has four fouls.
Pretty cool that time by Rigby. It's both free throws. Big possession here. How much time will Newcastle run off the clock, and can they get some points? Well, it's a one possession game right now. They're going to slow it down. Get that same play with Hahn on the outside, four players spreading the floor, trying to get him to drive the middle.
And if you give Hahn too much room, he's going to drive it all the way to the hoop.
Newcastle's in the bonus, so a foul means free throws. Hahn's the guy they want to shoot that free throw.
And look at that. He is just dribbling, and then he's fouled from behind. And that is the 10th foul against Jay County, so Zach Hahn has two free throws.
What a smart play that is. You beat your man offensively, and then you put the brakes on and hope that it'll hit you, because you know he's behind you, so he's going to try to catch up. Put the brakes on, you run into him, the officials call the foul. Got your best player on the line.
A very impressive performance tonight for the 6'1 junior. And nothing that we haven't seen all through this tournament for Zach Hahn.
Watch Steve Bennett now. He's cleared the lane. Getting this rebound is not as important as getting his team ready for defense and getting the rebound on a missed shot if Jay County can't convert. This is the most important defensive series for Newcastle in this game.
Well, Hahn missed the free throw. It's still a two-possession lead for Newcastle. Homer, three, short, rebound, Tower for Newcastle.
He just substituted Tower in, and he gets the rebound. A huge play by Drew Tower.
Inside a minute for Newcastle. Trying to win their first state title since 1932.
Hahn's going to keep control as much as he can. Don't need that three-point shot. They need it in Hahn's hands.
And now they foul Bennett.
They have to go right away to foul. As soon as the ball leaves Hahn's hands, they create the foul. Bennett, a 67% free throw shooter. And again, Newcastle back for defense. Jay County will need to get this rebound or inbounds pass, get down quickly, and try to get a shot.
Bennett had all four of his points in the first quarter.
It's a little easier, Chris, when you know you have two shots. It's not as crucial to make that first to get the second. So being in the bonus, a big help to Newcastle.
6-point lead for the Trojans.
Greg Tiggle wants timeout. 30-second timeout.
30-second timeout called by the Jay County Patriots. 37 and 2/10 seconds to play, and Newcastle has a 6-point lead.
What a hard-fought game this has been. Craig Peeper comes in with a great game plan to slow this thing down. Newcastle has a tough time adjusting in the first two quarters. Then they start to come back in this third and fourth quarters and now have the lead.
Let's take a look at our Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance game recap. Newcastle shot the ball right at their number. 45% on the year, 45% tonight. Look at the low turnover number for both teams, really. And the difference has been Zach Hahn, 28 points, 21 here in the second half.
This 32% for Jay County. Rigby's been their leading scorer. See if Newcastle puts a little pressure on Jay County. They want to run as much time as they can before Jay County takes their shot.
35 seconds to play. Rigby to Bruggeman.
Oh, the foul is on Newcastle. Rigby's going to go to the line. They blocked his path and not even the act of shooting. And Jay County gets to go to the line. Defensive mistake that time by Newcastle.
Brian Hazelman called for the foul.
Gonna let that guy cut through the lane and try to prevent him from getting the ball, but don't foul him just on the cut. The ball wasn't even going to him.
Rigby has 16. 46-41, Newcastle by five.
Rigby with the bonus.
Missed it. Bennett got the rebound. He's quickly fouled.
That's what Jay County has to do. As soon as Newcastle gets the ball, put him on the line, even though they get two shots. You can't steal it right away with the trap. You got to foul and go to the line.
Luke Bennett just hit a pair of free throws. He's 3 of 4 on the night. And again, two shot foul.
There's Steve Bennett. Don't foul the guy when he's breaking to the basket. Could tell exactly what he was talking to Hazelman about. Pretty cool Newcastle free throw shooting here in this fourth quarter with the game on the line. I think it's amazing, Steve Bennett. The players and coaches have taken every seat on the bench. They know he's not going to sit any part during the game.
He hasn't used that seat yet.
So why not use it? Let's let somebody else use it. He's been up the whole game.
48-41, lead is 7. That's a 3-possession game. Jay County has to work quick. 25 seconds to play. Bruggeman to the basket, scores. And Jay County gets a timeout. But if you're Newcastle, you don't mind giving up the 2. You didn't want to give up the 3.
Right, you want that clock to run. Expect a full court pressure now by Jay County.
Full timeout with 19.8 to play. Newcastle that far away from a second state championship. Just 19.8 seconds left, and Steve Alford, the Iowa coach, and the Mr. Basketball from Newcastle in 1983 is about to see his alma mater win a state championship.
Crucial inbounds play, full court pressure by Jay County. Newcastle's got to get the ball, hold on to it tight, and expect a foul as soon as it comes inbound.
And they get it to Hahn. He's their best free throw shooter at 86%. They can't even foul him. He keeps it on the dribble. He's going to dribble off about 6 seconds.
Good job by Hahn. He's able to get down the floor. You know, Newcastle had a player open, Hazelman at the other end, but they wanted that ball to Hahn. He did what he had to do.
Two shots.
Hahn had a 36-point game in the regional championship against Danville, and he missed again. So he's missed back-to-back free throws after making 4 straight.
Free throws made about even. Newcastle struggling percentage-wise, though.
29 points for Hahn. They lead by 6. 13 seconds to play. Patriots need a 3. Bruggeman fakes the 3, takes the 3, air ball. Bennett got the rebound. That should about do it. With 6 7/10 seconds to play, the Newcastle Trojans.
Well, you talk about great basketball tradition. Newcastle sells 4,500 season tickets to their great gymnasium in Newcastle. They've got a great following here tonight. And Steve Bennett will be the most popular man in Newcastle tonight.
And that guy, Luke Bennett, hadn't done a bad job either, Laz. He's hit the big free throws down the stretch.
He has. Zach Hahn, though, really the player of the day for Newcastle. The subs are coming in. Everybody getting a chance to play in the state championship.
50, Chris Clemens.
Brian Hazelman leaves. Now Steve Bennett's clearing his bench. And you're going to hear a big roar for Zach Hahn when he leaves. Chase DeGaulle will leave. I think maybe Hahn's going to stay on the floor.
Hasn't pulled him yet. For the 7-point lead with just 6 seconds.
And Bennett again. 6 of 6 of the line down the stretch for 5'11 junior Luke Bennett.
Big hug from his coach, Steve Bennett.
Biggest lead of the game for Newcastle. They're going to win the 3A state title. And that's it. Newcastle, they win the state championship in Class 3A. The Newcastle Trojans are the state champs. Zach Hahn has 29, 22 after the half. And it was his third quarter. He had 14 of their 20 points. Laz, what a stat about the Trojans in the second half. They did not have a turnover.
That's unbelievable, because this Jay County played a tough game. Took Newcastle away a while to get used to the style, but then they got it and they pulled out this game.
Newcastle wins the Class 3A state championship. Our post-game show will be next on the Indiana Cable Network. The Newcastle Trojans are the 3A state champs in Indiana in 2006. A second half comeback by the Trojans. They beat Jay County 51-43, their first state championship since they won their first one back in 1932. For Jay County, they end the year at 20-7. Newcastle 21-6. Let's go to the podium as we await the announcement of our Class 3A Trester Mental Attitude Award winner.
On behalf of the IHSAA, please join us in saying thank you to Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance for his generous support of our student athletes. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite his parents to join him on the arena floor. The recipient of this award while a student in grade 12 was nominated by the principal and coach. Excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school. Participated as a state finalist in this sport and was selected by the members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. The winner of the 2006 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award for Boys 3A Boys Basketball is Tyler Rigby, Jay County.
An outstanding honor for Jay County's Tyler Rigby, their leading scorer, two-time team captain, also a tennis player who reached the quarterfinals of the individual doubles tournament last fall with a 22-4 record. He's pursuing an academic honors diploma at Jay County with a 3.7 grade point average. Congratulations to Tyler Rigby, as Tyler Rigby is our Trester Award winner. Newcastle has won the 3A state title, and JMB is standing by with the Trojan head coach, Steve Bennett.
Oh, a very happy head coach he is. You know, we were talking about at halftime what you had to do in the second half to bring this thing home, and I think you pretty much blueprinted it, like you said, and got it done, huh?
Well, it started with defensively kind of cutting away the interior stuff they were getting, and then obviously Zach Hahn kind of put us on his back and carried us offensively, and that's his job to do that. He and Chase score most of the points for us a lot of times, but it's the seniors and the interior defense down there that do an unbelievable job.
You needed more possessions. You got that. You needed more of Zach Hahn. You know, ultimately, how'd you get that done?
Well, I think we spread it out a little bit. We gave him a little more room. We kind of got clogged up early, and I think the spacing on the offensive end was the big thing.
Let's talk about the list of good guards coming out of Newcastle. There's one guy sitting over there that was very good himself back in 83 as Mr. Basketball. How good can Zach Hahn be? He's got another year.
Well, you know, one thing he does is he's a relentless worker. It's not all that what you see right here. It's the summertime in the gym when it's 90 degrees. It's in the fall. It's coming and getting the keys at 10 o'clock at night. You know, he's committed to being a great player, and when you're committed, anything can happen for
you. Are you the mayor of Newcastle tonight?
Well, maybe not. I just love being their basketball coach.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Chris and Laz, back to you.
Thanks so much, JMB. One of the great personalities of Indiana high school basketball, Steve Bennett, a longtime assistant in the college ranks at Evansville. In his ninth year at Newcastle, he wins a state title. Newcastle 51, Jake County 43. Plenty more to come here at Conseco Fieldhouse. 51-43, the Newcastle Trojans defeat the Jake County Patriots. And there you have a look at Jake County, the 2006 Class 3A runners-up in Indiana. A year ago, they got beat in the sectional final by Delta. They finished 15-8. They advance a lot farther than that this year and finished their season at 20-7. A very good year for the Jake County Patriots, who I talked to Craig Teagle earlier in the week. You know, they really had no expectations that they could get this far here during this 3A season. But one guy who thought his team might be here, and he put him on his back, especially in the second half, Newcastle junior guard Zach Hahn with JMB.
Said it, Chris. Zach, you know, you needed more shots after that first half. They really controlled the pace a little bit. You got those shots in the second half, and you really didn't make it happen.
Yeah, coach just told me to keep shooting. You know, my shots weren't necessarily falling in the first half, and when you're the leading scorer on the team, you know, that's your responsibility. That's what your goal is, or object is on the team, you know, your role.
You know, how tough is it to get back a rhythm or control of a tempo that you seemingly did not have in the first half?
Well, you know, I think a lot of that had to do with the atmosphere of this place. We came out and were a little shaky in the first half, just like last week at Seymour, and then we came out and got it done.
All right, Darnell Archie, Brandon Miller, Bruce Horan, Steve Alford, the famous guards of Newcastle. Are you next in line with this?
You know, I don't know. I guess that's something that everybody else will have to decide.
I'll talk about it as much as I can. How about it?
That sounds good.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Chris.
JMB, I would have to think, and Laz and I are in agreement, I think you can put his name in that category at the high school level, and he still has a year to play.
Absolutely. What a great experience for him here. He's going to be a better player next year. Newcastle will have a strong team next year as well.
Zach Hahn, 29 points. You're looking at the Trojans now accepting their championship medals. And there you see Luke Bennett. He hit six big free throws down the stretch.
Free throws was the difference. 2 for 4 in the first half for Newcastle. 13 of 21 in the second. Probably missing more than they should have. But those 13 points, big in that third and fourth quarter.
Zach Hahn played all 32 minutes. There he is, 29 points, 7 rebounds, 4 assists, 10 of 19 from the field, 4 of 7 behind the arc. And he put them on their back in the second half.
Assistant coach Jay Knox. Assistant coach Dave Allen. Assistant coach
Well, what memories these kids will have as the state champs. Class 3A in Indiana.
Assistant coach Ed Hyatt.
We're not done yet, Laz. We got another one, and the potential history-making game is coming up with Lawrence North. But Muncie Central would like to say something about that.
There's Steve Bennett, 12 years an assistant coach at Evansville for Jim Cruz, former teammate of mine at Indiana. Liked the high school in Indiana so well, became a coach, but took a great plum job in Newcastle. Can't get much better than that. Look at that smile. All the Newcastle fans here. Kent Benson is here for Mr. Basketball, a teammate of mine in Indiana. He's here in the stands. They're receiving the championship trophy right now.
And there you see it. Newcastle, the 3A state champs. So Newcastle joins Hauser and Forest Park as state champions today. Who will win Class 4A, Lawrence North or Muncie Central? That's coming up. There you see it again, Newcastle holding high that state championship trophy. They win it in 3A in Indiana tonight, beating Jay County 51-43. But a nice award for Jay County senior Tyler Rigby. He is today's Mental Attitude Award winner in Class 3A. He is standing by with JMD.
All right, Tyler, I know that it wasn't the ultimate goal, but at the same time, it was one terrific run for Jay County.
Yeah, I think so, too. It was all about the team this season. We play so well together, offensively and defensively. That's what makes it so hard to beat.
You know, somebody called in my radio show this week and said, you don't know too much about Jay County, but when you see them, you will like what you see. And seemingly, that's just a fan of yours, but at the same time, that's the way you play. People like the way you play, and certainly you didn't get it done today, but it was a very good shot at a very good Newcastle team.
Yeah, they're great. I want to congratulate them on their win. They're really tough. They got a couple of tough players, but the role players play such an important part in that too, just like our team.
And we'd like to congratulate you on your award as well.
Thank you. It's an honor.
All right. Chris Denary.
Thank you, JMB. Tyler Rigby, the Mental Attitude Award winner. There is Newcastle in the green. They did it back in 1932. This was their ninth appearance, their first since 1984. JMB talked to Sam Alford, the head coach, back in 1984. He had an opportunity, along with this great contingent of Trojan fans, to watch Newcastle win again. We'll have a whole lot more for you coming up at Conseco Fieldhouse on the Indiana Cable Network. Chase DeGaulle, the sophomore, holding up that trophy and the net as the Newcastle Trojans 51-43 over the Jay County Patriots. Chris Denary along with John Laskowski. Newcastle gets it done. Laz, what was the key for them in the second half?
Well, as Coach Bennett mentioned, defense and rebounding made the difference. They only got rebounded by two. That was not the case in the first half. And then defensively, they made it tougher for Jay County to score, made a lot of free throws. Zach Hahn, that's the difference, as Steve Bennett mentioned. Zach Hahn took control of that game, scored the 29 points, led his team to the state championship.
All right, we've got highlights to look at as we show you what happened in this game tonight. And it was Jay County early with Tyler Rigby, the Mental Attitude Award winner. He had three threes in the first half, but Luke Bennett hit one, and then Hahn got on the board early on.
They weren't always easy shots as he hit off-balance shots. Remember, Jay County made those five three-pointers in the first half, but they struggled, just two in the second. That bank shot at the half gave him a real edge going into the locker room, but it was all Zach Hahn in the second half. Rigby hits one there. But then here comes Zach Hahn. He can shoot from the outside. He can drive to his right and dish to a teammate, but he really likes to drive to his left, and that did it. Newcastle is the 3A state champion.
So Newcastle does it. Now we're going to look at the final stats, and there you see it. The Trojan shot the ball very well at 46%, 50% behind the arc, and low turnovers, four for the game. None in the second half.
And rebounding ended about even. No turnovers in the last 20 and a half minutes. Very unusual for any team to do that, but Steve Bennett will look back at the single stat most important, probably that turnover stat. Possessions were so important in this ballgame.
All right, Newcastle wins it 51-43. They're the 3A state champs. When we come back, we'll tell you what happened earlier today in the Class A and 2A state championship games.